Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are studying related to the aldehydes, ketones, and carboxylic acids. We studied it as IUPAC name and electronic structure. Today we will study preparation of aldehydes and ketones. Now, while we will be studying it as in preparation of aldehydes and ketones, first of all, we will see such type of an reactions in which we can prepare both aldehydes and ketones both. Only the thing is, depending upon the initial reagent, the product will be changing through aldehydes or ketones, right? Then we will be going it through specific reactions through which we can produce only aldehydes and only ketones. So first of all, we'll study those reactions in which we can produce both aldehydes and ketones at a time. And that is already we have studied it. The first one, reaction from from alcohols. Now when we studied it in the chapter of alcohol, the oxidation of an alcohol, the same reaction is there, right? What is it? Primary alcohols on oxidation produces aldehydes, and secondary alcohols on oxidation produces ketones. Let's recall it by the help of the reaction as well as the reagents that will be required. We will take it as an primary alcohol. For this, the reagent that can be used, you can use it as an any of the weak reducing agent, K2CR2O7, H2SO4. By using K2CR2O7, H2SO4, we get it as an, because it's in primary, we get it as an aldehyde. If we would have taken it as secondary alcohol, then by K2CR2O7, H2SO4, we would have got it as ketone, right? So what does it show? Primary alcohol produces aldehyde, secondary alcohol produces ketones, right? In place of this K2CR2O7, H2SO4, we know it that we can also use it as PCC, CRO3, maybe Na2CR2O7, H2SO4, any of it can be used as a weak oxidizing agent. So alcohol produces aldehydes and ketones, right? Depending upon this, what we told, method is same, only the initial reactant is different. Primary, secondary got converted into aldehydes and ketones, right? Similarly, from the same alcohols, by dehydrogenation, that means of alcohols, we got it as again primary alcohol, it produces aldehydes, whereas secondary alcohol will produce ketones. In this case also, it's a same condition. Primary produces aldehyde and secondary produces ketone. Let's see the reaction. RCHO, which is a dehydrating agent that we are going to use it? Cu at 573 Kelvin. We need it as a copper at 573 Kelvin. The compound gets converted into, here it was CH2OH, it gets converted into CHO. If we are having it as a secondary alcohol, Cu573 Kelvin, we get it as ketone. So again, by using primary, we got aldehyde, by using secondary, we get it as ketone. Again, reagents are same, reactants are same. Only the compounds of the reagent that is primary or secondary, the nature differs, and the product changes. Okay, third reaction. Actually, these two reactions you studied in the previous chapter of standard 12th only, alcohol phenol ethers. Now the reaction that we are going to do it, that is we are going to recall it from the standard 11th, the chapter 13, the hydrocarbons that we did it. The particularly we are recalling it as ozonolysis. Right? We are going to go it for the first one, alkenes. When we are going it for the ozonolysis of alkenes, what will happen? When we are having it as in C double bond C and O3 is added, then during that case this double bond is dissociated and reacts with ozone to produce ozonoid, which is unstable. It produces unstable ozonoid. This unstable ozonoid, it's reacted with H2O, which gives out H2O2, and it dissociates itself into two molecules, like dissociating it from here. So one is produced as CO, another one is produced as CO carbonyl group. But again, what will happen? This is a carbonyl group. It produces carbonyl, but what will it get converted into, aldehyde or ketone? Where it depends? It depends upon the valency of the alkenes that are completed. See, for example, if we take it as an alkene with CH3CH, double bond CHCH3, right? So both the sides we are having it as an one carbon and one hydrogen. If I add it as an O3 in it, it will be getting converted into an unstable ozonoid. This unstable ozonoid will dissociate itself by adding in water in it. The product we are going to get it is a CH3CHO, two moles. That means we are getting it as an aldehyde. Now the same component, only the thing is, in place of H, we'll take it carbon itself, CH3C, CH3, double bond, CH3, CH3. That means this time both the valences are completed by carbon. So in this case, if ozone is added, the compound we will be getting it this is the different huh? We will be getting it, on adding it we will get it as ketone, 2 moles of ketone, right? So this shows that by ozonolysis of alkenes, we are going to get it as an aldehydes or ketones, right? Okay. Now in place of alkenes, if we take it as an alkynes, by any group, then what will happen? This compound, in place of ozonolysis, we will be going it for addition of water. In place of ozone, we will go for the addition of water. During this case, again, by adding it, H2O, what will happen? As per the Markovnikov's rule, one is going to get H, one is going to get OH. But because of the double bond and OH group present on the same carbon, it goes for rearrangement. It gets converted into C double bond O single HH. Right? So what is this? This is particularly known as tautomerism. This particular process is known as tautomerism. Now it depends, again this will produce aldehyde or ketone. It depends upon the position of triple bond. If triple bond is at terminal carbon, then it is going to produce aldehydes or ketones majorly on the terminal. We don't specify it because compound to compound it will be varying it. Like if we are taking it as CH3C triple bond CH, now this is on the terminal carbon. If I'm going to add a water, I'm going to get it as CH3C OH CH2. Right? This is fixed as per the Markovnikov rule. OH, H, lesser number of the carbon, carbon containing hydrogen, it will be OH group. And this on tautomerism, H goes over here, double bonds come over here, so it gets converted into ketone. Right? But in place of that, if I'm having it as in suppose specifically triple bond, then only we are going to get it as one is H, one is OH, and again tautomerism takes place and it gets converted into CH double bond O CH3, that means aldehyde. Right? So this is for the hydrolysis of alkynes, triple bonded. Double bonded we went it for ozonolysis. Right? By these four methods that we saw it, all these four methods, what we are saying it, depending upon the carbons that are having it or the functional group present, the nature of the functional group, it produces aldehydes or ketones. The next reaction that we will be doing it, we will be doing it all for only and only aldehydes. Methods to produce only aldehydes, in which the first one is Rosenmund reaction. Right? What is this reaction? We are having it as a COCl. It's reacted with H2 in presence of PdBaSO4. This compound PdBaSO4, it's known as Rosenmund reagent. Right? It's reacted with COCl. It gets converted into CHO and HCl is given out. By this method, ketone cannot be produced. The second one, Stefan reaction. When we are talking about the Stefan reaction, it's reaction of cyanide, RCN, SnCl2 plus HCl. When you are having it as an RCN with Sn2 HCl, it gets converted into RCH double bond NH. This compound on hydrolysis gets converted into RCHO. This is Stefan reaction. Now in place of using this reagent, we can also go it for the other reagent, the same for nitrile. That is Dibyl H. Actually, what is it? Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. We term it as Dibyl H. Diisobutyl aluminium hydride. What is it? When we take it as NCM, reacted with Dibyl H, when we are reacting it with Dibyl H and then followed by hydrolysis, the compound gets converted into aldehyde. So CN group can be converted into CHO by two different reagents. One is known as Stefan reaction and another one with the Dybbal-H. Dybbal-H means diisobutyl aluminium hydride. Okay. So third reaction that we are having it, that is Gaterman-Koch reaction. Again, this is a very important reaction because benzene is directly reacted. This reaction will be useful for conversions. Benzene, it's directly reacted with CuHCl. It gets converted into CHO. CuHCl, this reagent, it's carried out in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. It gets converted directly into aldehyde. Okay, next one, hydrocarbons. In specifically aromatic, we are taking it as an CH3. Again, for this also we are going to get it as two different reagents and we are going to name it as Itard reaction. We are going to name it as an Itard reaction. This reaction, which is reacted CH3 with CrO2Cl2. Chromyl chloride, this one is known as chromyl chloride reagent, right? What will happen? It will produce an intermediate, first of all an intermediate which is unstable. Immediately on hydrolysis it gets converted into a stable product. It gets converted into CHOCROHCl twice, right? It gets unstable. So on hydrolysis by H3O plus it gets converted into CHO. Right? Now particularly we wrote it as an Itard reaction. If I don't want to use it as in this reagent, the same component, it can be reacted with CrO3 in presence of CH3CO twice O, anhydride. At that time what will happen? Again it will produce CHOCOCH3 twice, which on hydrolysis gets converted into aldehyde. So you are changing the reagents. Though the components, reagents are same, reactants have changed, our product, final products are same. We got it as an aldehyde. So that is from the hydrocarbon, specifically toluene, that will be used. Right? The next one we are having it, that is the reaction with that is again side reagents. It's a toluene on chlorination in presence of sunlight. We get it as CH2Cl. HCl is given out because it's a sunlight. Sunlight, the reaction takes place on alkyl group and not onto the aryl. If I want to go it for the chlorination in dark, then it would give me orthopara product. But this is in presence of sunlight, so I got it as CH2Cl. Again, further chlorination, we get it as CHCl2. Now, using this CHCl2, if aqueous NaOH is done, what will happen? The compound will have the Cl replaced by OH. It's an unstable. We know that two OH group cannot remain on the same carbon atom. So it will immediately go for breaking of the molecule and it will get converted into CHO. H2OA is removed. So this also produces aldehyde, right? So we got it as a different reaction: Rosenmund reaction, Stefan reaction, Itard reaction, Gaterman-Koch reaction, and the unnamed reactions also. By using different reagents, we got it as an aldehyde, specifically aldehydes produced, right? Now we will see it as an the other one for ketones. Only for ketones. This time we will be seeing it those reactions through which only ketones can be produced. Aldehydes cannot be produced by those methods. So in it, the first one, by using Grignard reagent. We know it that we are using Grignard reagent means RMGX. It's reacted with CDCl2. I'm taking 2 moles. So what will happen? 2 moles of RMGX reacted with CDCl2. So both these Cl's will react with this and we'll get it as R2CD and MgxCl. 2 molecules are removed. Okay, now this R2CD, it's reacted with RCOCl, acid halides. It gets converted into 2 moles are taken. So we get it as RCOR plus CDCl2. So this component is obtained back and the compound gets converted into RCO2ISO, 2 moles. So by this method we get it only ketones. The second one, again for the Grignard reagent only, but by using cyanides. Cyanides, when we are reacting with R-MgX, it gets converted into R double bond N MgX R dash, and the Grignard followed by hydrolysis produces ketone RCO R dash. So we get it as ketone. The third one, acylation of benzene, specific reaction. We are having it as an CH3 COCl acylation. This reaction is carried out by anhydrous AlCl3. It gets converted into COCH3. This was also known as FNC reaction, Friedel and Kraft reaction, right? Now in place of CH3COCl, we can also carry out the same reaction by using CH3CO2ISO. Again in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. It also produces the same component, acetophenol. Both of them are producing acetophenol. Reagents are different, right? These were all the different methods for preparation of aldehydes and ketones. Right? For today's lecture, this much reactions are more than enough. We will do further the physical properties of these aldehydes and ketones in our next lecture. Right? Thank you.